Hello and welcome to the module 2 of our exploit development series. In this module, we'll learn another technique of developing an exploit, which is structure exception handling overwrite, which is nothing but a variation of buffer overflow. So these are the few software that I am assuming that you as a learner have a basic knowledge of. If you don't, please check out the resources at the end of this video to learn more about the software, or if you want to learn these from scratch, these resources will help you in that also. So like a previous module, this module is also structured into 6 parts, which is introduction, fuzzing, POC creation, controlling the execution, bad character analysis, and finally cracking the shell. We are on the first part, introduction, wherein I give you a brief overview of what the technique is and what tools do we require for it. So these are the tools that we require for this module, a virtualization software. It can be either VirtualBox or VMware and a Linux machine. I will be using Kali Linux 2018.1 as a VM and a file fuzzing tool. I will be using FileFuzz. The download link for it is mentioned in the description below, so please check it out. I will be needing Python 2.7 on both Windows and Linux machine, and for my text editor, I will be using Sublime Text or Notepad++. You can use either of them. I will be using both on certain occasions. And our target machine is Windows XP SP3. I will be using it as a VM. And our debugger will be Immunity Debugger. And we'll also be needing Mona library for Immunity Debugger. And our target software will be DVD X-Player 5.5 Pro. Again, the download link for all these software is mentioned in the description below, so please check it out. So let's see what is structured exception handler. So it's nothing but a mechanism in Microsoft Windows to handle an exception. So let's go through a diagram to understand it in a better way. An SEH is a linked list of exception handlers. So it contains a pointer to the current exception handler record and the next exception handler record. Since the stack grows downward, we'll encounter an SEH first and then the SEH. So now let's say an exception arises in a program. So a program checks our SEH handler and it asks it, can you handle this or not? So an SEH handler can say either yes or it can say no, and the program moves on to the next SEH handler record. So in a similar manner, the chain goes on. Now let's assume that the last exception handler here accepts that, okay, I can handle this exception. So what this exception handler will do is it will first push all the contents of the structure to the stack, and then it will continue to execute the instructions that are there to handle that particular exception. Now at the time of exception, the location of current SEH is ESP plus 8 and the location of next SEH is ESP. So how do we exploit SEH mechanism? Now to exploit SEH mechanism, we send the program an overly long string, and with that string, we can overwrite the SEH pointer and the NSEH pointer. So now all we have to do is overwrite the SEH instruct or the SEH pointer with the pointer to pop return instructions, which will decrease the stack by 8 bytes. And then the ESP will be pointing to the NSEH. And on the NSEH, we'll write the opcode to jump to the location that we control, and on this memory location we will place a shell code through which we'll obtain the shell on the target machine. So that was the bird's eye view of SEH overwrite. As we'll move to the other modules and we do a practical example in the lab, things will get more clear. Meanwhile, if you have any doubts or you want to learn more about the techniques or tools that we are using in this module, please check out these resources. Thank you for watching this video and I'll see you in the next part. Meanwhile, please subscribe to our channel YakshasCSC and follow us on Twitter. Our Twitter handle is @Yakshas443. And if you want the files and slides for this module or the first module, all you have to do is tweet about one of the modules and mention our handle so that we know that you have tweeted about us. And once we receive your tweet, we'll send you the link to download these files via Twitter DM.